Protocol to Middle Tennessee. This protocol, which includes the revolutionary peace shot along with acoustic wave therapy, treats the issue and doesn't mask it with medicine. Treatment time is less than 30 minutes with no downtime. Increase stamina and even size. For a limited time, get this treatment package at a special introductory price, offering a huge 55% in savings. Go to edgepeptide.com to schedule your appointment. This sports hour brought to you by traininfo.com.
Bring home unstoppable comfort with a new Train heated and cooling system. At Train, we test so it runs. Visit traininfo.com to find your local dealer. It's hard to stop a train.
From the WinBet studio, win with WinBet. WTFX Gallatin, Nashville.
A Cumulus Media Station.
The Titans and the Chiefs. Kickoff is Sunday at noon on your home for Titans football. Trending now at 104.5 The Zone.
It is 3 o'clock. Good afternoon. I'm Lucas Panzeca. Titans return to the practice field out at St. Thomas Sports Park. Not spotted during the open portion. Punter Brett Kern, receiver A.J. Brown, Derrick Henry, Monty Rice, Taylor Lewan, and Chester Rogers were not out there. Julio Jones did return, got some stretches in before doing some work on his own. Randy Bullock back at practice. Jeremy McNichols and Chris Jackson as well. The Braves are one win away from the World Series after last night's 9-2 win over the Dodgers. Braves hit four homers, held the Dodgers to four hits. Eddie Rosario with two home runs on the night. Game five is tonight, a 7:08 first pitch in L.A. Braves can seal it with a 3-1 series lead. The Astros lead the ALCS 3-2 after last night's 9-1 win over the Red Sox. Game six is on Friday night. Nashville Soccer Club played out a 1-1 draw against Columbus Crew in Nissan Stadium on Wednesday. Still sitting in second in the Eastern Conference, four regular season games remain. And the Preds are back in Bridgestone tonight, hosting the Rangers. Puck drops at 7 p.m. Thursday night football is in Cleveland. The Browns hosting the Broncos. Baker Mayfield out tonight. Case Keenum will get the start, a 7:20 kick. Westwood One coverage can be found right here on The Zone. For all your foundation repair and waterproofing needs, visit USSTN.com. Breaking news at once on your home for the Titans and Vols. This is 104.5 The Zone.
The 3HL with Brent Daugherty, Don Davenport, and Ron Slay.
Welcome in. It is 3XL. Hope you're having a great Thursday. And based on where you are in the city, you've either got beautiful weather, like we have out here at Music City Autoplex, or it's raining so hard you can't see 10 feet in front of you, like on the drive through, I don't know, Brentwood on the way out here.
Yep.
So wherever you are, enjoy your day. And we'll try to make it a pleasant one for 3 hours here on 3HL. Brent Daugherty, Don Davenport. Hey, Don.
Hi. Hello. Happy Thursday.
And despite how she just responded there, she's on edge. So I'm going to go ahead and tell you that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
So look out.
What edge?
As Mr. Babb says, running red. Running
red.
The other day, red. He asked if any of us wanted to go home with y'all.
I running red that day
too? You were talking about, I think, flights to the Army Navy.
Yeah, that's
Navy. Yeah. I was running. Dang, yeah, because do I run red a lot?
Listen, we're gonna broadcast live from the Army Navy game, which will be phenomenal. We'll do the show from the USS Intrepid, which
this
the social
is gonna
media
be amazing.
Part of that. We'll try to take you guys with us, basically, so to speak. But yeah, they had Slay and I on two flights at like 5 o'clock, meaning we would miss the Thursday show before that Friday.
On a different flight.
And so I said, it's
a different airline than me.
And so Dawn was flying out at like 8. So we were like, hey, Dawn, you can do the show by yourself. We'll just, we'll just go on up there. We'll wait for
it. You got
and,
it.
And so anyway,
what was Coach Mack's call? What was the end of not just yes, yes?
Nobody. What?
Hell yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hell that yes. was my response.
Not yes. Hell yes.
That's right.
Hey, there you go, Panda.
But mine was no, though.
Guess who else is here?
Not no. Yeah. Not no. Hell no. We're all going to be on the same flight.
The one and only Ron Sylvester Slay.
Hey, I'm in the building.
Best believe I'm in the building.
Well, that means it's a parcel.
I'm in.
You got a parcel coming?
Building. Car ain't got no roof.
Time for the show.
Let's go.
You know,
if
you ever close your eyes and do this,
I get dizzy.
Oh, man. And then you open them this place.
You got like a little low-grade headache.
Yeah, it's wild. It's wild, man. It's like when your mom tell you, man, don't you drink that fast, you're going to get brain freeze. And you do it anyway.
Hey,
so I just did it.
We've got Denver at Cleveland tonight in the NFL.
Oh.
We also have the Atlanta Braves trying to get to their first World Series since 1999.
Oh. Is that tonight too?
Yes. Do I smell a parsley coming?
Now, wait a minute. Hold on. Because I'm going to have to make a correction. I thought they were going to play Friday.
Nope.
They play tonight?
Yep.
Three nights in a row?
Yeah. Because they're in L.A. No travel days.
That's 2-3-2.
2-3-2.
Wow. See, I'm used to basketball.
Red Sox and Astros played last night in Boston.
Boom.
Houston won. Takes a 3-2 series lead. They're one win away from the World Series. And they're trying to get to their third in 5 years.
That's dope.
They travel to Houston today. They play tomorrow.
Man,
so
I
Braves
rethink,
trying
man.
To close it out
in LA.
Tonight in L.A.
Oh, okay. I got to reconfigure. I'm gonna go talk to some of my reps that are in the parsley room. Talk to them. Get my calculations together. Sim it, cause I got a system. I sim it to, just like on Sportsline with AB and them. I got a system too.
So my view in my head of the parsley room is like. Like these guys have got like, you know, button-down collared shirts, like short sleeve.
Okay.
They've got like multiple pairs of glasses.
Oh, yeah. Sunglasses, though.
Yeah.
Not regular glasses.
They there's just smoke all in the room
yeah.
from cigarettes, not from stogies.
Right.
And
No, stogies.
Yeah, they're smoking.
Oh, yeah,
no,
stogies,
they're smoking
yeah.
cigarettes.
No, not in the parsley room.
No, these guys are smoking cigarettes. They're high intensity octane guys.
They're
locked in. And
what kind?
Inside the parsley room, it's a room about as big as the Music City Autoplex lobby here.
That's yeah.
But there's a ginormous computer. Remember back in the day when all the computers were like huge.
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
And like War Games.
Yeah.
Matthew Broderick and War Games.
Yep. The big TV at Just for Feet.
And there's this huge computer, and it just spits out these little cards that have numbers on them.
See. I'm starting to think you've been in there.
I might have.
And you know it's a retractable roof because when we hit, we ain't got no roof.
All kinds of fireworks go off.
Boom.
So parsley tonight at 5:45, you think?
You better believe it. When you hear that music, people, you know. When you hear the remix to the OG, you know what it is.
If you were listening yesterday, we've got two things for you in this first segment.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll get to Titans Chiefs. We'll get to Preds update, Nashville SC update. NFL game tonight, update Braves, all that stuff. We'll start to work through everything. But two things.
Yep.
You listened yesterday. Number one, Ramon is taking credit for beating Don in the race to raise money for breast cancer awareness.
Hey, man.
Now, we know that there was some cheating going on.
Man, I just had a talk with him. Man.
We have two documented cases that we know of.
That's just that we know of.
Listen.
Of cheating.
See what I'm saying?
And the cheating is that Becky from sales.
Yeah.
Donated, put RF after her name, which meant her donation went to Ramon's credit. But then when we came on, she tried to do it again and to give DD credit, but it went to Ramon again.
That ain't.
And so she did it again, and it went to Ramon again.
It's not right, man.
And then Tammy, who helps with the marketing at Two Rivers, she did it too.
She backdoored it too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's two documented cases.
Mm-mm.
So
that we know.
No, we're not.
That we know of.
We are not allowing this to be a final count.
Nope.
We're going to get all of the people in the parsley room involved
yes.
because
oh, they serious
that's
too.
All they do is numbers.
And they they license the carry too. So act up in there.
Recounts.
Yeah. And Babs the one that got them their license. Recount.
That's hashtag right. recount.
Yep. I just
no,
had
don't
a,
hashtag
you know what?
That.
The crazy thing, I just had a talk with Ramon yeah. about that.
Please don't include us on hashtag.
No, we're out of that. We're not in that realm. No, we stay away from that realm.
No, exactly. I just had a talk with Ramon about that, and he's never, ever pleaded the fifth with me. That was amazing. Like, we talk about everything.
He played the fifth?
That man played the fifth. It's just me and him. Like, yeah, like it was lawyers and stuff in there. I just tried to go to him back door, talk about the conversation, about the recount. And the man said, I plead the fifth.
Uh-huh.
Hey, man.
So it's something. Hey, it's something
your fishing. Silence tells me everything.
Come on, man. I'm trying to tell him. Talk to me.
All right. There's item number two. You ready for item number two?
What's number two?
Where did the barbecue stain come from that is on the 104.5 The Zone table skirt?
Yeah.
That we take to remote?
Yeah. Yeah.
So Ramon tried to blame us for that.
Yes, he was wrong again.
Because of Buffalo Wild Wings. But I know for a fact, because I was there, neither me nor Ron Slay.
We always eat together.
ate our wings anywhere near the table.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
And so I usually...
It was not us.
I usually do, but I did not that
you
night because baby Babs and Mr. Babs came, so we ate elsewhere.
Well, in addition to that, I've done some investigative research. My man Keith Morrison will tell the story later, but...
Huh?
There's a source close to me that indicates that we didn't even use that skirt at Buffalo Wild Wings.
You know
we
who
didn't
did?
Use,
I've been framed.
We didn't use that skirt at Strikeout Wings.
Oh.
We used that skirt at Calhoun's in Knoxville.
Oh.
Is that right?
Ron Slay on one side of the table, Ramon Foster on the other side of the table.
Oh.
Is that right?
Oh.
Who is to blame, Ron
Which
Slay?
One is it?
We do have photographic evidence that we will present later.
Is it the taller brother
this
or
is
the
opportunity
shorter one?
Where you can take credit.
Now, hold up.
By the way, Ramon shorter.
Now, hold up. Now, let me explain something. In this situation.
See, what happened
in this whole situation, man, I was, what's the word?
Fried?
No, you weren't fried.
I wasn't fried
because
I just started.
I saw you right before you went over there.
I was baby fried when the food came, though.
You might have shotgunned a beer.
I shotgunned a beer.
Who was it? Bobby Graham's wife? Bobby Graham used to play wide receiver at Tennessee.
Emily, my FF, yep. And then.
He calls her his FF, not even BFF.
Yeah, I took the B off. We that close. So.
What, like friends forever?
That's right.
She's phenomenal. I spent five minutes with
you
her.
Love
She's
her
phenomenal.
Babs. You love her. I'm telling you. Should be there. Don't worry.
I mean, she almost, like, she might have beaten him.
She came close.
In shotgunning a beer.
Like, we the best tag team when it comes to shotgunning that you're going to find. So, did that. Then, as soon as we walked in the door at Calhoun's, I was presented with two beers. And they just started, like, he's in the building. And they started giving me beers. And I had to jug them, so.
For the record, we have no beers here at Music City.
Oh, no. But we would love if they did. I'm just saying. You know, we don't, though. I'm just saying, though. But
they do have fountain drinks over there, they do.
What if I, you know what, when I see
fountain. There's nothing better than a fountain.
Oh, I always want to put my head under it and let the.
Okay, that's gross.
I know, but that's why I'll never do it. But, like, I always want to do it. I always seen it in the movies, man.
We'll see if right. Music City Autoplex will let you do it today.
I think he's talking in circles now.
Yes.
We've left.
What do we have
hotel.
Today?
We did. Y'all took off with me. So
yes.
I was a little baby fried, and then the food came, and it's Ramon's fault because he ordered like a smorgasbord of stuff, and I love them wings, the Thunder Road sauce, and I was getting
Thunder
extra,
Road sauce
I get
great
extra Thunder Road sauce.
Yeah.
So I'm not admitting
it. Was wrong.
No, I don't know. I'm just saying it could have been because I was double dipping in my sauce with the ranch, and then coming back in the Thunder Road, and then hitting it. But then having to pick my mic back up, so I don't.
Oh,
okay.
That,
like,
I was blurred at the time.
I'm always going to battle for you.
You got to go to Babs. Don't give up on me though.
But
don't
oh my gosh, no, this is like a mini confession.
Here's what I appreciate.
Geez.
I appreciate the honesty though.
Yeah,
because I don't get any of that from Ramon Foster.
Yeah, see. Here,
oh no. There's no honesty.
Bingo.
There. See, what time is he on today?
5:00.
Yeah.
5:20.
5:20.
5:20.
5:20.
Yep.
Okay. All right.
Twin,
so we got
twin.
Ramon then. Greg Cosell today.
At 4:20. Yes. Yeah. The NFL matchup show is Saturday at 7:30 in the morning. One of the games they're doing is Tennessee and Kansas City.
Nice.
That's beautiful.
So yeah, Greg Cosell at 4:20. And we've got tons to get into today. We still have your topic that we haven't gotten into, Babs. About kids not wanting to be cussed out now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. We kind of hit on it a little bit yesterday.
We did. Yeah, we could dive. Man, it's not Who Framed Roger Rabbit. I'm going to have to call my reps, man, because it's Who Framed Ronda Slay.
Listen, Jessica Rabbit in that movie? I know she's a cartoon. Music City Autoplex, you hear Ron Slay talking about these guys all the time. We would love to see you. Off exit 2, off Vietnam Vets. And Kirby said it's 300 yards on the right.
Hey.
That's what he said.
It could be.
We'll go with it, Curb.
300 yards off the right. All right. More for quality when we come back. And we'll get to a Tennessee Titans injury report at some point. 3HL, 104.5 The Zone.
We have the best broadcasters in the NFL. So why wouldn't you want Mike Keith and Coach Mack on your smartphone?
He can run this thing. 40, 45, 50, 45, 10. What an effort.
Hear every Titans game by downloading the 104.5 The Zone app.
Week 7.
Check out a new kind of used car dealership committed to serving the Nashville area, 2430 Gallatin Pike North. Big thanks to John, the general manager here, for having us out here.
John.
Bringing this little Johnny. Circus. What kind of circus did we decide that we are? Did we figure out what?
Oh.
What? Where the Ringling brothers are from? How many of them are there?
Yeah, Kirby came up with something. I don't really know how true it is.
Guess
Kirby.
What?
Especially since he came with this
I don't
stuff.
Care.
What does What does the P and the T stand for in P.T. Barnum?
Yeah.
What is Bailey's first name? I mean, these are questions that are out there. But
and I said Jonathan Bailey.
Jonathan Bailey?
Yep.
JB?
Yeah, and who cares? I mean, because did they do the sauce?
I don't know, but we're a traveling circus. Denver and Cleveland tonight. Cleveland by 1.5 currently, but that line's moving because there's a lot of injuries involved in this
whole
team.
Lot. Line, running backs.
Both teams are 3-3. Cleveland will be without Baker Mayfield. First time he'll miss a game due to injury in like 7 years.
Mm.
But his deal
and
is,
he doesn't want to miss.
No, that, yeah.
I mean, he is like his shoulder keeps falling out of socket, and he wants to keep playing.
Listen to me, Babson.
He's crazy.
And one of the I'm telling y'all, I'm gonna say this every single time we're on there, or this brought up. One of the worst injuries on earth is your shoulder popping out. I'm telling you. Knees, back, ankles, wrists, whatever it is.
Back is pretty bad, though.
It is, but back is really bad. But
why?
Shoulder is unbearable because it's hanging.
Because it's painful?
It's painful.
Because it's heavy and hanging?
Yeah, and it's hanging and you can't lift it or anything. And the dumbest thing about it, about your shoulder being out,
the dumbest thing about a shoulder injury
is it takes them, when they put it back in, they say count to 10, and they'll put it back in by 3. So it's like a suction. As soon as the doctor's 1, 2, 3, and it sucks back into your shoulder, and it's right back in. And
that's
like
skydiving with the Army Golden Knights. They're like, all right, we're going on 5, and they go on like 1.
You know
what? Because you tried to bail.
Well, yeah.
I'll bail.
I mean, she's trying to get out of it. She was all in to do it. And then they opened the door. She's like, do I really have to do this?
And I've been giving you all these props, babe.
And he was like, we're going to go on 5. And he goes, 1. Boom. They're out the door.
Gone. Yeah.
Dude. I was like, so guess what I was thinking about.
Were you screaming curse words?
No, I don't. Because you're falling at like 170, 50 miles per hour. So you can't get it out. Yeah.
I said they counted to 5 and Babs jumped them out the plane.
Oh, no. Uh-uh.
No.
So like his back was to the door, right? And like he had you.
No, I was in the door.
You can't do that. I'm face first.
Oh, you're face first.
In the door.
That ain't good. Look.
And you don't realize how fast you're flying until the door's open.
Oh no, you're sitting on Southwest drinking like whatever back in the day when
back
you could have
day,
a drink.
Yeah.
You
can't
eat door. I mean, you just see things go by real slow.
But I'm like hooked to him.
Yeah.
So he just pushed me.
So if he's going, you're going.
Yeah.
So if I
so my it. My feet stayed there, but it didn't matter because he just pushed.
Come on. Hey man, that's wild.
All right,
we're
going on 5.
So he couldn't
1,
hook me.
Boom.
Because I'd be bigger than him. It'd be like the baby.
It would be interesting. I mean, they would have to find some. God.
Maybe I have to go with 2.
They need a bigger door too.
They
would. Right?
They need a bigger door. They need a bigger tandem jumper with you. I mean, you'll have to.
You and Ramon could jump together, just hook to each other.
But we wouldn't get out the door. They have to do like the aircraft carrier.
That'd be a fast free fall.
Like on Transformers. And we just take off running. That's how we.
Yeah. So
I always say that about synchronized diving in the Olympics because I'm always amazed that women are willing to do that because my thought is one will hit the water before the other. And women don't want to be involved in something like that. But somebody told me it doesn't matter how big you are, you're going to hit it at the same time.
They're different athletes, right?
So, like him and Ramon jumping out of a plane with you and your guy, like you and your husband.
This Hunter guy.
You would. Yeah, sorry. I don't know anything, Travis. So, you would hit the ground at the same time if your chutes didn't open as them.
Yeah. I doubt it. I think we'd go first. We're a little heavier.
Really don't want to talk about shoots not opening.
Right,
but
exactly. Well,
so back to
anywhere.
Baker Mayfield's shoulder.
Yes, so shoulder, back
Ian
to that.
Ian Rappaport said they're going to do surgery on his labrum at the end of the season. He's going to try to make it through the season.
Yeah.
Now, if he takes some more hits on it,
he's not gonna be
it's going to be too painful to do anything.
I'm going
to
tell you this right now. I guarantee he don't even have to take a hit. As soon as he does a movement that he doesn't think about, it's coming out.
That's the problem.
It can go back in, but it's not.
That's the problem at this point, that there's nothing that's tight enough to hold it in place.
Right, because his labrum is torn.
Exactly.
So it's just going to pop out.
Yep.
So then why not just play tonight? I mean, if you're going to try to make it through the season.
Dude, because if that thing come out, man, he's going to have to get shot up with all kind of stuff, and I don't advise that they do that.
That's rough. That's rough. Different.
Well, so Case Keenum's going to start for Cleveland. Here's the other thing. Bridgewater for Denver, he's hurting too. He's got a foot and a quad. Yesterday we had the toe thumb. Today we got the foot quad.
Mm-hmm.
Whose defense is going to score?
I don't know, but if you want Denver, get it now because it's 1.5. Cleveland by 1.5.
Along our side, I got it for 2. Just saying. If I were to take them. But I don't know because the parlay hasn't come out yet.
Hypothetically.
Check again, Jim.
As he's checking right now.
Our traveling road circus here at Music City Autoplex. By the way, their website, musiccityautoplex.com. We've got a guy on hold that knows something about shoulder injuries. Is that where we are? As I'm trying to pull it up right now, let's go to Ed in Nolensville. Ed, what's up?
Hey, this is Ed. I know all about the shoulder injuries. I had my first shoulder injury playing backyard football, being tackled in the end zone, popped out of place, and couldn't believe the pain, could barely stand. I had to grab onto a fence and pull it back into place because there's no doctor or medical personnel around. But I ended up having surgery. He's going to Baker Mayfield, if he keeps playing with that thing, he's going to throw his arm back, which puts the shoulder in the weakest position. It's just going to pop out of joint, and he's going to drop the ball.
Yeah, see,
I eventually had to have my shoulder replaced and can now lift 25 pounds with it. So,
oof.
I mean, he's playing with fire if he's going to get out there and play.
Yeah, here's the thing. It's his non-throwing shoulder, but if you think about it,
that's still
affected because you extend that left arm before you throw with the right.
You're not going to throw like this. If you're looking at me on zone TV.
It looks like he's in a straitjacket. Speaking of, it's like Mel Gibson in Lethal Weapon when he gets out the straitjacket.
Bingo.
He takes everybody's money because he can pop his shoulder out of place. Same thing. Baker Mayfield could do that.
Listen, man.
He could do tricks.
I begged them to put my shoulder back in the socket, and they would not do it.
How did you hurt yours?
I went up for a rebound, extended, looking this way as I'm coming down to start the fast break because, you know, I'm like a point forward.
Yeah. But see who's running up the floor and where.
Yeah. Because I'm not passing, I'm going to start the break. But I'm looking this way, and a little wild guard, I don't know why guards are trying to rebound anyway, a wild guard comes out of nowhere and tries to snatch the ball out of my hand, and I try to grab it instinctively. And before I know it, my arm went back, and it popped out.
Ugh.
And everybody, it was so bad, everybody on the court stopped and said, ah! And I was sitting
there. So you could really tell.
Yeah, I was like this. And I'm like, what's going on? And I tried to pick my arm up, and it wouldn't go nowhere. And I'm like, oh. Oh. So I ran to the tunnel, and I told, hey, man, please. But mind you, it's a playoff game. We're on the road team's court.
Where are you? Like in Greece or something?
I'm in France.
France.
I'm telling them, please put my shoulder back in. Please put it back in. Before this pain sets in. I know it's coming, but my adrenaline kicking right now.
Yeah.
They say, we can't do it. Because you have to sign off on it, and we're not your doctors. I say, dude, bring me any piece of paper. I'm going to sign it. Put my shoulder back in. They let it sit out for 45 minutes. Then a 30-minute more ride to the hospital. I get to the hospital. I got to the hospital.
You needed a bottle of something.
Yeah, I did. I got to the hospital, and I'm sitting there, and the doctor, I'm holding my arm. Every bump, any movement, it's excruciating pain. As soon as I get there, the doctor... They had me fill out some papers. I said, man, please just put it in. I'm going to fill the papers out later. They bring me some pills, about 5 pills. Take them. Pain leaves immediately. I go sit on the table. 5 minutes later, the doctor said, count backwards from 10. 10, 9, 8. And I was good. I couldn't move it. They took me to a witch doctor and everything to try to play in 2 days. And I was with it. They did all kind of little.
No, that's real.
That's for real. Like I went to a real doctor, a witch doctor, all kind of doctor, holistic doctor, to try to get my. And there was a little bit of movement, but one movement, man, and it's coming out. Like you cannot protect it or anything. You can't wrap it. There's nothing you can
do. There's nothing you can do because you got to use it in the game. So here's the thing. I mean, you got to protect that investment long term.
That's the thing. Dang, I just said what you said. You said that's the thing, and then I said that's the thing.
Because it is the thing.
It is the thing.
Good thing, the guy.
The thing, come on.
Listen, I would, just as a side
if
note.
If I'm their doctors, I mean, that's.
Yeah.
As a side note, number one, I'm thinking of a lot of things in this story. French guy ain't going to want to help an American.
Right.
Number one.
First.
Number two, I would pay a really large amount of money to see you with a witch doctor.
Oh,
like,
man.
I would pay for that show.
Dude, when I walked in, I almost lost it. It's candles lit everywhere. It's some kind of little music playing, like, kind of like Michael Myers-ish or Jason-ish. Like, you know what I mean? Like, somebody chasing me, but I'm standing right there. Like, it was, but it was, like, it was weird, man. The candles lit. The lady told me lay down, put some oil on it, asked me have I had any other injuries. I said, man, don't worry about the other injuries. Worry about this. And, dude, it was weird, man. Like,
it didn't work at all?
Nah.
Maybe because you weren't bought in.
No,
that's mental. That's an all mental thing.
No, I wasn't bought in there.
That's why it doesn't work.
The candles in the music did it for me, babe. That's where I'm at. Massage therapy, a wicked witch house.
The mind is a powerful thing.
Ooh,
a little help from a witch doctor, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Ian Rappaport.
Yeah, it's rough.
Speaking of injuries, Ian Rappaport tweeting this. We do have the injury report for the Titans.
We do.
Titans, who have dealt with skill position injuries, trying out wide receiver Pharaoh Cooper.
Yeah, South Carolina.
Running back Dontrell Hilliard and wide receiver Brandon Powell.
Okay.
For, this is for?
They have Tuesday tryouts.
Titans, Tuesday tryouts. There you go.
So this is.
Just prepping just in case.
So the Titans always have Tuesday tryouts?
NFL.
Why, are you interested?
No.
He's looking out for
how's
his
that
offensive
shoulder?
Line. That's parked outside the facility.
So this is even more reason and more to my point why it's not going to work. Like, if it's a trial.
He's gone,
Tuesday.
Right, now? I mean, he finally let it go?
No, I think somebody else, he went to California or something for some other trial.
Oh, well, good.
Yeah, no, great for him. But this is the reason I'm saying. Like, you got trials every Tuesday and they just skipping over you? You're not. I ain't going to say you're not that good, but you ain't that good, bro.
I'm not going to say it, but seriously.
Yeah.
Was that the worst pain injury-wise you've ever had? Because you've had some serious stuff. You had the back. What is it? The
The L5-S1.
Yes.
Surgery. So that
you've had
right
ACLs.
There,
that's the Caleb Varley.
Have you had break?
Yeah. I had a wrist break.
Wrist break.
I want to hear more about the wild guard, though.
Who?
The wild guard. You make it sound like you said this wild guard.
Oh, man. Little guards are wild, like 5'10 guys, 5'9 guys that's out there on the perimeter that's super athletic. You still ain't got no business on the inside.
Don't come in
yes,
here.
We do.
No,
do you know what rebounding is?
Yes.
You know what rebounding
effort
is?
And energy.
It's effort and energy.
You are exactly
are
right.
You saying that short people can't have the effort and energy? I bet you I'd out-rebound you right now.
You probably would.
It's all about effort
you beat
and
me up the ground.
Energy.
You got to beat me up the ground.
Well, first of all, I can back you on out of there.
Babs, I put this rear in. It's a wrap for you. I'm telling you. I'll use mine. I know what to do with it.
I use mine, too. I know what to do with it.
I got nothing on this one.
I'm not going.
This using
have you
the
seen,
rear end thing.
You seen my legs from back in college? Watch out now. I could squat it.
Babs, you better beat me up.
I could squat Ron Slay.
You could squat a Music City Autoplex car.
That's right.
Man, the injury pain, though, is
hating
serious.
On the guards.
You make it sound like wild guards are like, you know, in the Mutual
man,
Omaha
wild,
special.
Man. They are, man.
They're out there with the hyenas and stuff.
Russell Westbrook's a wild guard. I don't like him. I don't like him. Stay away from me. This paint is for me.
Who was this guy? Do you remember who he was?
A French guy. French guy. No, all French guys.
Wild guard and French.
Yeah. French wild guy. Always wild. I'm telling you, man. I know this for a fact in athletics.
Oh, man.
Yeah. You saw it. Ease Pons. So a miniature Ease Pons. That's what he was. People that don't remember, Ease Pons played for University of Tennessee basketball, playing with the Grizzlies now.
It wasn't that long ago, Slave. Surely people remember him, right?
I'm trying to get in the habit of telling people what I'm talking about, though.
Okay.
So, you know,
that's good.
I'm schooling myself.
No, that's a good call.
But you saw Ease would go hit his head on the rim trying to block shots. Like, this is wild. Imagine a little 5'9 guy doing that and I don't even see him.
Man, I love that effort.
Man,
I hate that your shoulder got torn. But
Babs, I wish you was their coach. Because I was looking at their coach when they walked up. Like, why you got dude in the game, man? This man out here wild, man.
I just, like, picture this little Tasmanian devil guard.
He had little dreads like a Tasmanian devil. It was him. I'm telling
coming
you.
Coming at
you. I'm telling you.
Like that Geico commercial with Animal
and
in the
attic.
And he
was the first one that said, oh, because he knew he did it.
Yeah.
Like, Man, my arm. That moment.
Oh, by the way, I went back to watch the Titans game again, and I guess I had a bunch of people talking in my house during the original viewing of the live event.
Yeah.
But man, when Cam Batson tore his knee up,
so
and it was all quiet, and you could hear him screaming.
Yep.
Oh,
you can see it.
That like grates.
If you ever had a knee injury, as soon as it happens, you know it. You know if it's an ACL. I said it's ACL immediately. When I saw the cut.
Yeah. You know, I mean.
Done deal.
And then he ran into his own guy.
Done deal.
All right. Injury report. A.J. Brown, illness. Did not practice. He's still dealing with it. You hear that, Hunk?
I feel you, bro. I feel you, bro.
Oh,
did you eat Chipotle?
Hunk? No. No, I didn't. I didn't eat Chipotle. I think my son did, though. And it wore off.
Hunk needs a Pedialyte.
Yeah, drink up, Hunk.
I'm worried about you, Hunk.
Man.
Telling you, I've been there. It's buddy, ugly. Like,
just know that if at any point in time Brent says we'll be right back on 104.5 and we don't be back, we're not back, just...
We don't be back.
We don't be back, there's a reason.
Like me.
I love the 3HL dictionary. yes, a friend of mine told me Pedialyte and Tito's.
Now...
Gonna say that might burn coming back up.
What? Nope. Electrolytes and
electrolytes and vodka. Yeah, you're taking care of business.
That's tough.
So. Randy Bullock, kicker, did not practice yesterday. Full participant today. That's good. Okay. Chris Jackson limited today after not practicing yesterday. Julio Jones limited today after not practicing yesterday. Taylor Lewan, concussion protocol, did not practice. Jeremy McNichols, ankle, limited today.
Wow.
That's good news. He hadn't practiced since he did our show.
Yep. Yep.
Chester Rogers, groin, did not practice. Those groin injuries just linger.
That's serious. I think I got one now.
Left or right?
Is that why you're sitting like you are?
Yeah, that helps me.
Feels really?
Good. Yep. Feels good on my
hips. I mean, those are brute.
Feels good on my hips, too.
I've had
He's
one.
He's got his leg left. His leg.
The groin is right
his
here.
His left leg over his right leg.
What is this?
No. That's not your groin.
What's your groin?
He pointed.
Show to, do I have to bad. Show
yes, you?
He pointed to his.
That's what I said.
Oh. Oh, your legs
can
are
both
just
of
so
you please sit down? Please.
I'm a bad
Y'all can't do this right in the middle of the car dealership.
No, we had to see where
it's
it is.
It's right. It's like here.
Don did the Baker Mayfield.
No, mine's higher.
Remember when Baker went and like showed the other team what was what?
Yeah.
That's what she did right there.
That's the groin. Yeah.
Yeah.
Where
but,
were we?
But that is it. I mean, especially as a receiver, like trying to.
Cutting,
separate, cutting, burst,
load,
all of that. Like, ouch. Ugh.
Unbelievable conversation. Kari Bassett gave full participant. Monty Rice, limited yesterday, limited today. That's good. Roger Saffold, full participant. Bud Dupree, limited today after not going yesterday. Derrick Henry did not practice after not practicing yesterday. Rest.
You know what?
Rest.
I want to say something about those injuries when we get back because that mentality, man, the guys that are getting hurt, consistently, and this goes to your point, and I hate this. I hate it because it's like everything that I stood for. Caleb Farley, I want to address that when we get back.
All right, we'll do it. 3HL, 104.5 is up.
Coming up tomorrow on Blaine and Mickey.
It's Football Friday. We'll give you a Titans injury update from Titans head coach Mike Vrabel ahead of.
Music City Autoplex. That's where we are. Exit 2 off Vietnam Vest. Way and Slay's doing his Red Dog commercial. And it's pretty quiet in here.
Yeah, it is.
In the lobby. Mm-hmm. And there's a gentleman and a young lady talking behind Slay. And he's all quiet. And then, people in the lobby almost jumped out the chair.
But that's what it's about, though. That's when the dog comes out.
My favorite part was the look, like, after the scared set in, and then it was, like, the angry. Yeah,
this guy's a nut.
It looked like wild
Who's
guards.
This fool?
Well, thank you.
Who's this fool?
I'm so, sorry. Kansas City is 3-3, and I know you're going to make your point here in a second,
mm-hmm.
but check this out. They're 3-3. Their wins have come against Cleveland, who's 3-3, Philly, who's 2-4, and Washington, who's 2-4. Their losses have come against the Ravens, who are 5-1, the Chargers, who are 4-2, and the Bills, who are 4-2. So the Chiefs' wins have come against teams with a combined record of 7-11. Their losses have come against a combined record of 13-5. I'm not saying. I'm just saying. Don always likes to talk about who have you played.
I did. I talked about it with the Bills.
How much do we know about you?
The Bills came in to last week with wins over teams that had a combined 8 wins.
Yeah.
So that's one win better than the Chiefs.
That's true.
Right?
Yep. True. True. And I love it as a temperature check for the Titans because in the beginning of the season, I'm huge on not moving the goalposts. The beginning of the season, I said the Titans were a top five AFC team. You know, and I had my third.
Okay.
At the time, behind Kansas City and behind Buffalo.
Yeah.
Baltimore, I gave my edge on Baltimore because I didn't know how Lamar was going to come out playing like this. Like, so I can't go back on it now, but just saying.
Lamar. I'm not saying.
I'm not saying. Just saying.
Hey, man, we're on the same wavelength today. Can I touch on the injury thing?
Yeah, hit it.
So,
Caleb Farley.
It's Caleb, and it's. I don't want to make it like it's towards Caleb Farley, but he's the guy that came into it with injury prone.
Right, he's the example here.
Right, exactly. Like I could use Bud Dupree and everything, but.
There was talk about Caleb. Just to set this up, there was talk about Caleb prior to him being drafted. Not just the back injury, but there was a history of. And I don't want to say catastrophic injuries because you can't come back from catastrophic injuries, but
ACL and two back surgeries.
But serious, yes. Serious injuries prior to being drafted.
Right.
So there was history there, and there was talk from some that maybe you want to stay away from somebody that has such a long history of serious injuries.
Correct. So to that point, I always speak from a perspective of me going through and my experiences with the injuries. To date back, when I tore my ACL, I also had meniscus first. I bounced back pretty quick. It was 4 to 6 weeks. I was back in 4 weeks ready for the season. I missed 2 games to open our season in college my freshman year. Outside of that, then I had the ACL, which was a major injury. With that being my first major injury, to me, my mentality that was set up for my wrist, for my back, my shoulder, and everything was all that mentally, like you said, the mental part is huge. The mind is a powerful thing. I automatically think, oh, man, I'm going to be all right. I just got to do the rehab right. I'm going to bounce back. In his situation, his first one hasn't gone well. You know what I'm saying? Like, the back injury, okay, he felt like he was bouncing back. Then it was something else lingering with the shoulder. Mm-hmm. And now you got the ACL. Like, mentally, I wonder if he'll be fragile and able to rebound from it. I'm sure, I hope he will, you know, because you're a pro athlete, this, that, and the other. But, man, mentally, if you're weak, it is going to be super difficult to bounce back. Like, I was different because my first injury, I was able to get back. In 6 months, I was released. And full go from my ACL. So I think that set me up for the future. If I have another injury, I can bounce back quick, just do the rehab, attack it hard, and not have any setbacks. In this case, it's happening so rapid.
And like, it's back to back to back, basically, for him. And, I mean, so there was talk, too. You know, he didn't even play at Virginia Tech his last year.
Right.
And So you lose now the taste of what fires you up and makes you passionate because you haven't been able to play the game a lot within this time. And that's what fuels you, right? Yeah. Yep. That's what drives you. That feeling of competitive and being there in a game environment and out there ready to go. And how often do we talk about this? And it's interesting because I worked the Oregon game last week and they have just had a rash of injuries. And talking to Mario Cristobal, he was like, you know, here's the deal, because they've had injuries to their key players, their leaders, their vocal guys that they rely on, right, for Oregon. And I'm like, well, where do you fill those shoes from the leadership standpoint, at least on the field, off the, you know, where? Mm-hmm. And he was like, they're still around, because when you're injured like that, it is so easy to fall into depression, to feel like you're away from the team, like you don't matter, to feel like feel like you're not. So they, at Oregon, they don't break down in practice until they have all their guys out of the training room, out there with them. You know, all the injured guys go to meetings. Mm-hmm. It's not like that in the NFL.
No.
Because this is a business. It's not about, hey, you know, we want you in here because we necessarily worry about you still feeling like a part of the team. Like, being injured in the NFL is a very lonely, lonely experience.
Totally
agree. Now a rookie is there again.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing. And people wonder, like, when we do the Mount Rushmore, I always put somebody from the training staff on Tennessee Volunteers when I do that Mount Rushmore, on that Mount Rushmore. Reason being, I had something to look back on to say, oh, if I do it like this, Jamal Lewis tore his knee up and went and was a top 10 pick.
And then tore it up.
And then tore it up. You know what I'm saying? And then so forth and so on. Big Worm, Big Billy Ratliff,
Big
Darn
Worm.
Walker. It was always injuries that I was able to point to. And like you said, with pros, you're off to yourself. At least there, I'm in the training room with other football guys, volleyball, whatever it may be. And to that point, when I hurt my back, I don't do my surgery over there. I said, man, y'all got to let me go home. And where'd I go? Straight to Knoxville, where I know the rehab, and I know there's going to be other people in there. And
you get the support.
I'm in that atmosphere of where I bounced back the first time. Let me do the same thing here. And it was right back. So,
Brent Doherty, Don Davenport, Ron Slay, 3HL. Hour number two coming up. Kansas City Chiefs quarterback Patrick Mahomes, 8 interceptions already this season. Why? 3HL. We'll talk about it. 615-737-1045.
Titans have their sights set on Andy Reid's AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs.
1045 to Zone Thursday edition. We're getting closer to the football weekend. Brent Doherty, Don Davenport is here. That's her Mr. Miyagi hi.
Hi.
I like that hi.
Hey. She is headed to, where are you headed? Minnesota?
Minnesota. Row the boat, PJ Fleck. Yes, Maryland at Minnesota.
Uh-huh.
I get to see.
Fear the Turtle.
Tungavaloa's little brother.
Oh, yeah.
What's it? 2A.
Hey, Don, what's the temperature going to be like in Minneapolis on Saturday?
Talia is his name, Talia. Honk. You said that with way too much excitement. I don't want to talk about it, honestly. I don't want it to be a conversation and actually suck it. So.
Huh?
Where are we going, Minneapolis?
It's a low of 30.
Oh.
It's a high. Now, here's the good thing. My game, by the way, ESPN2. If
are you
want to look.
Minneapolis? Is that where you are?
Yeah. 2:30.
Oh.
2:30 kick. Tune on in. Yeah, so at least it's the hottest part of the day. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, the end of the game, the sun will start to go down, but it's a high of 50.
But the sun will come up tomorrow.
That's right.
Coach Mack can tell you, Don, you got a jacket.
Yep.
You'll be ready.
You'll be ready.
Yeah, low of 30 on Friday, high of 51, low of 37 on Saturday.
Yeah. Like, it's about to be like fall, winter here. Y'all get ready.
Dude, yeah, when we
remember Halloween? Right, a lot of times Halloween, it's freezing here in Nashville.
Freezing.
Listen, we were in Minneapolis for the Super Bowl.
We weren't really in
Minneapolis. Like, we were at the Mall of America, which is outside of the city.
I love the Mall of America.
Yeah, the high one day was -4.
What?
Seriously.
I'm like, man, if you can't even throw a zero at me, I'm always of the opinion, like, if your high temperature is one syllable, you're in for it.
Wow.
It was awful.
You can't even get
and
me a
we're
13.
Inside. I mean, yeah, you can't even give me a zero?
That's tough.
No. Yeah. So I'll take, I guess, the high of 50, right?
You should.
But it is. It's going to be chilly. Yeah.
AJ Brown just tweeted. Wait. There he is. He's Ron Slate.
Hey, what up?
Hey, I'm in the build.
Best believe I'm in the build. Better be ready. I'm in the build. Car ain't got no rules. Time for the show.
It's a really good beat.
Best believe I'm in the
build. Red B. I miss you, Red B. I ain't seen you all week.
Man. How many takes did it take for, like, all of these little sound bites?
Oh, no. Mm-mm. Nope. One take, lay it down. Red, this is what
one
Red said.
One take, slay.
Red said, say this. Say this. Say this. And say this.
You know what we need?
And it was on.
Oh, I thought he pulled it from you saying that during shows.
No, he told me to come in.
We need to make a Ron Slay, like, stuffed animal type thing.
Oh, no, Bab's got a great idea.
And just pull the string.
I haven't really.
Car ain't got no roof.
Oh.
And then you pull it again.
Lock the door.
Yeah.
So, there you go. No, we were talking about, what is it, Hunk? Blippi?
Yeah, Blippi.
Yeah, Blippi. We're going to take Blippi
anyway,
out of the game.
Yeah, so, and I looked up the dudes. For those that don't have kids and don't know, he's like a kid. He has a kid's show. He goes to, like, museums. And he's weird. But anyway. His net worth is $40 million, and he's 32 years old.
Listen, if your net worth has more millions than you have years on this planet,
you're doing all right. No, so I was like, because Hunk just had a full night of watching Blippi because his sweet little son is sick. But I'm sorry about that.
Ollie, okay. Man.
So I was like, we need a Ron Slay show.
Yep.
That's a kid's show. Like, kids love Slay.
Big Slay love the kids, too.
See?
Well.
I can see it already.
I'm with you. Come on,
let's go get in the sleigh ride.
Yeah,
now, our car ain't got no roof, but it's okay. That's an okay thing for this.
Hey, and see, then it teaches safety, because when you get in, all the kids repeat after me, lock the door. Lock the door.
There
you know what I'm saying?
Like, see?
That's it. We're gone, Bab.
We're done.
We don't know.
Speaking of stomach issues, AJ Brown just tweeted, my body is rejecting any food I eat. This ain't no joke.
Wow.
Bro, that's my son. My son's going through the same thing.
It is, but if it's food, here's the deal. If it's food poisoning, like, it should be, once it's gone,
in and out, it should be out.
And you're good, right? Like, mm-hmm. 24 hours at the most, you're done.
Yep.
But
like,
see,
why is he still having issues?
I don't know. Pedialyte and Tito's, though, because, like, you're hydrating and you're dehydrating, but you're having fun.
You're hydrating and you're dehydrating.
But you're having fun.
You're having a ball. Having
That's concerning, by the way.
But guess what?
And you don't know why you're throwing up. You don't know if it's because of the sickness or the alcohol.
It doesn't matter.
Guess what? I got. I think I got it.
What do you got?
AJ Brown was in the Hunkerverse, and he passed it to Ollie.
There you go.
Hey, he did have a game last night.
The Hunt Titans did play last night.
See?
Against the little computerized Chiefs.
Oh, now they're little and computerized after they beat me for four straight weeks. Yeah.
Hey, Hunk,
I just pulled it up. He threw a Derrick Henry. He threw a Derrick Henry stiff arm into the end zone. And Hunk is like, I showed Babs. I was like, look at little Hunk. He's in the corner, like the bottom corner. You can see Hunk. And he's talking about how Jackrabbit needs to play defense just one time.
Please.
And so that was like a separate rant. But but I showed Dawn, and you've got this huge computer screen showing the football game, and then there's this little bitty picture of Hunk, video of Hunk in the bottom.
Yep.
And you said what?
Hunk's look Hunk looks creepy.
What?
Is that what you said?
I didn't say that.
Oh, my bad.
That is what you said.
What?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Listen, she did the Ramon. She played.
Listen, Slade tried to own up to the barbecue stain on the skirt.
What?
Yes, I did.
No,
it was just the picture.
I just thought about it.
It was like tiny and in the corner, and it was more mohawk than Honk, and it was just real creepy.
But you're still kind of screaming about Jackrabbit playing defense,
right? I did appreciate that though.
Yeah, you're not wrong. So AJ Brown, his body's rejecting any food.
That's tough.
So if any of y'all have any remedies that you would like to throw that don't include Tito's and Pedialyte, hit him up on Twitter at 1K Always Open.
Rest. Rest. Get some air.
I mean, in all seriousness, hydration.
Yeah,
I mean,
hydration.
You water, 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 water.
You can't take nothing. You got to get some IV.
Well, you know he was, I mean, you know he was dehydrated prior to the game. It was IVs, he get him ready to play.
3.5 IVs,
wow.
I think, is what I heard.
Yeah. That's tough.
Yeah, like I said, I'm concerned if his body's still rejecting things. I mean, it's Thursday.
Yeah.
That was, what, Saturday?
Monday.
I know, but Saturday was when.
My bad.
I understand that, but I think it was either Saturday or Sunday that he showed up on the injury report as illness.
This is really what Slay was saying when he said that. Hey, Don, you know they played Monday Night Football on
right.
Monday.
Yeah, no,
that's
I do
what
know
he really
that.
Said right there.
No, I didn't. No, I did not.
By the way,
my response, what I really wanted to say was, Jackleg. Yeah. I'm talking about when he ended up on the injury report the first time. For an illness, I believe that was on Saturday or Sunday. So all I'm saying is my concern is that this maybe isn't just food poisoning.
Right. I'm with you.
Is there any fear that the Chiefs are going to get it going? Like just snap the finger and it happens this week and they get it going offensively, defensively. They don't turn it over. That's been the big thing for them, turnovers.
Right.
Patrick Mahomes has 8 interceptions already. He had 6 all of last year. 5 all of the year before. So 11 in more than 30 games. He's got 8 in 6 games.
I mean, Ryan Tannehill has been sacked 20 times and was only sacked 25 times all of last year.
But
so,
guess how many times was he sacked on Monday night?
None.
Zero.
Zero.
None.
Zero.
And David Quesenberry, right tackle, graded really highly, real high, real highly. He graded highly.
He graded well.
I don't want to use two adverbs in one sentence.
Yeah, you cue up Afro Man.
Afro Man. He graded highly for PFF.
Yeah.
So the metric people indicate that Quesenberry played really well at right tackle. Saffold, I went back and watched. Like, he told us on the long run he didn't get to celebrate with his teammates because there was a Buffalo Bill guy that was laying down in front of him, and he just kind of ran him over with his knee to the back of the guy's head.
Yeah.
Like a speed bump.
Yeah. We tied.
Could you see it?
Southern hospitality.
You couldn't. I could see the guy that was on the ground, and I could see Saffold running toward him. So it's almost like I could see the car hit the deer before the car hit the deer.
Yeah.
But then I missed the car hitting the deer.
Makes sense. Makes sense.
Right? So
I agree.
I don't know. But I saw Ben Jones in the end zone celebrating, but Saffold wasn't there.
Yeah.
But, man, everybody had a good block. But what's funny on that play? I'm sorry, Big Nate Davis. He didn't block anybody on that play.
No.
Not one person.
That's real.
But it still went 76%.
That's all. Sometimes the best bet is to just move out the way and don't touch it. Let the people
move out the way.
Yeah, don't even worry about what's going on.
Because Swaim.
And don't hold.
Don't hold.
Swaim caved that whole right side in. And then he cut Ra off him. And then NIL had a block.
NIL. We'll take NIL. Speaking of NIL, man, we are at Music City Autoplex. So come to us. 2430 Gallatin Pike.
So are you saying if you're a student athlete,
yeah,
come by?
Most definitely. Great computer. I don't know. Great pewter. That was computer and people. That's all I was going to say because I'm looking at a computer. But great people, great atmosphere. Get the job done. Highest inventory in the Middle Tennessee area. And I'm going to go as far as the South. So now, low mileage vehicles. I'm telling you what, I came here twice. I'm here three times now.
I still want to see you take a test drive.
So. I want people, listen, man, come by, test drive a car, and take me with you.
Oh, that
take
would be
me
fun.
With you. Yeah, lock the door, take me with you, come right back.
Fun or scary?
Scary for them, fun for me. I'm going to have a blast.
Oh, you going to be the one driving?
I'll drive if they want me to drive. Yeah.
Or you just sit in the back seat, put your feet up on the dashboard?
Listen, I test out anything they want to do. If you want to have no roof or put a man on the roof, I get on top of the roof. I get in the trunk. Make sure everything cool in the trunk while we're riding. Just saying.
We'll be here until 6 o'clock.
Music City Autoplex, yep. Baby. We're in the building.
Coming up next, Greg Cosell will break down everything. He's the best in the scouting world, and he's been watching film. We'll talk about what happened in that Titans-Bills game and definitely look ahead to the matchup with the Kansas City Chiefs. That's coming up next. Stay tuned. 3HL 104.5 The Zone.
Do I have everybody's attention now?
Coming up tomorrow morning.
Ramon Foster is off for the day. Auntie Kayla Anderson of News 2 will co-host the show with Jason. He's your favorite bi-monthly hate listen, Jeff.
less per carat than the equivalent round number.
We've got Craig Cosell with us on Zone TV. You can watch us there. Twitch.
Twitch, please.
YouTube. That's another popular spot to catch it. And on Twitter, the link is out there on our Twitter feed at 3HL1045. Brent Norty, Don Davenport, Ron Slade. Craig Cosell with us as we walk through some film. He's the best in the business. Executive producer and analyst for NFL Matchup, which, by the way, you can see Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. Nashville time. On ESPN2, or if you're like me, after the Tennessee Ole Miss game at like 3 in the morning, I caught up on some Greg Cosell at that point. Also senior producer at NFL Films for 42 years. Greg, what's up? How are you?
I'm doing great. I see you're the mayor. Is that it, Brent?
That's somebody a long time ago pinned that nickname on me. Said I sit right on the fence.
Hey, you don't need to explain that. Yes, he asked you a question. Just tell him to answer the question, Greg. What is that about?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm giving the reason.
Question.
Yeah, it's a very
kind of
simple question.
Kind of a weird thing to have a nickname. We all can't be Big Slay.
Yeah, I am. Some can.
Greg, a lot of teams put a lot of guys in the box when they play the Titans defensively. But Buffalo didn't really do that, did they?
I would say Buffalo kind of played their normal defense, you know, because Buffalo is – at their core, a nickel defense. That's their base defense. They play nickel. Last year, they played almost 90% of their defensive snaps with nickel. This year, it was the same. And they did exactly the same thing against the Titans on Monday night. In fact, this season, they've only played 10 snaps in what many would consider a base defense, meaning a 4-3 with three linebackers. So they stayed with nickel as their foundational defense. I'm sure there were some tweaks to their defensive alignments, which, you know, you have to be in the meeting rooms to know exactly what those are. But for the most part, they kind of did what they do. And I'm sure they felt they could line up and play. And by the way, guys, I would say for the most part, they did that and it worked. I mean, we know that Henry had the 76-yarder and he can do that in any given game. And I would argue, just as an aside, you could easily make the argument that as we speak right now, he's the single most dominant individual player in the league. But the point I'm trying to make is I don't think he killed them in the way he often kills teams. I thought that they won the game in the second half more because of their play-action pass game as opposed to Derrick Henry.
Okay, but that's kind of like saying, like, oh, the plane crashed because of a bad landing. But other than the bad landing, it was okay, right? Like, but the 76-yard touchdown run.
Well, I mean, no, but my
no,
point
I see
on
what
is
you're
this.
Saying.
My point on is this, that Derrick Henry is going to get carries and yards. You know, rarely, if you look at his last whatever number of games, first of all, in his last five games this year, he's averaging, I think he has 725 yards in his last five games. So you know he's going to get yards. Obviously, you don't want him to break a 76-yarder. So my point is not that Derrick Henry was not a factor in the game. My point is that I think their offense really started to hum in the second half when they did that staple, what I call bang play action, which we've seen for the last number of years with the three-step drop, the quick five-step drop, and they hit they hit Brown on the in-breakers. Brown had seven catches in the second half after having no catches in the first half. So, no, I don't want to come across as if, oh, Derrick Henry doesn't matter. Of course he matters. Their offense starts with Derrick Henry. But I think most defenses probably feel that he's going to get yards. He's number one, he's going to get carries, and he's going to get yards. Do you want to stop the 75-yard touchdowns? Of course you do. But he's going to get carries and yards.
You mentioned a little bit A.J. Brown and play action pass. What made that work for them?
Well, that's something, Dawn, they've done for the last number of years. We can all visualize, if you're Titans fans, the number of times in the last 2 years with A.J. Brown, now in his third year, where he's caught those quick in-breakers and he's broken for long runs or long touchdowns. So that is a staple of what they do. They just haven't been able to get to it this year the way they've done it the last 2 years. So it finally showed up in this game. Now, this is where the Henry factor is obviously big, because anytime you go play action to Henry, those stacked linebackers will step up and you create space between the linebacker level and the safety level, and that quick bang play action throw on, whether you want to call it a slant route or a glance route, that throw's there. So it finally showed up in this game, and it was really critical in the second half, because I think that if I'm not mistaken, I think Tannehill ended the game with 9 straight completions.
Yeah. Because I thought he struggled yeah. early in this one.
Yeah, he was 9-9 in the fourth, and then completed his last pass in the third. Yeah, he started slowly.
So. Yep. And they really have not been able to get this year to their passing game the way we've seen it since he took over from Mariota in 2019 and what we saw last year. So the pass game, for whatever reason, maybe it's continuity, maybe it's Brown being out of practice a lot, Jones being out of practice a lot, but there hasn't been continuity to their pass game this year the way we've seen the last year plus.
And that's pretty much why it's important to have a guy like A.J. Brown and Julio out there at the same time, right?
Yep.
Because it opens up so much for him. I don't think we get to see those big breaks without those two guys out there, because you look at the games that they didn't play, and it was hard to get those breaks in the game like that. So he's going to get carries. He's going to get yards. Does this offensive line plugging guys in continue to play this way like they did on Sunday?
Well, you know, Ron, it's really interesting you ask that question, because – you know, I've been doing this a long time, and I remember having conversations going back years and years with coaches, and a lot of coaches will say that the back makes the run game more than the line. Now, obviously, if your line stinks, that's different, but, right. but you know, this line doesn't stink, you know. So Henry is the kind of back. Yeah, Henry's the kind of back that can get yards. So, you know, I think that the offensive line, to me, is not an issue. You know, is it the best O-line in the league? Probably not, if you went, you know, left to right and looked at other offensive lines in the league that are very good. But this is a solid offensive line. They've been together now. I mean, keep in mind, I know Taylor Lewan got hurt. Thankfully, he's not seriously hurt from what I understand. I don't know if that means he plays this week or not. But the point is, he'll be back. It's not going to be a long-term thing. So you got, you know, Lewan and Saffold on the left side. There are times they're phenomenal together. You got Jones, who's been playing a long time. You got Nate Davis now, in his third year, is it, I believe?
Yes.
Yeah, and he's been a starter since his rookie season. Mm-hmm. Quisenberry's been on the right side all this season. So this has been a line that understands cohesiveness. They've worked together. This is a solid O-line, and they run block effectively. And Henry, we know that Henry is the kind of back that if it's blocked for 3, he gets 6.
Right,
And right. sometimes he gets 20. So, I mean, yeah. there's no issue.
76.
Yeah. There's no issue with this old line in terms of what they want to get accomplished.
Okay. Greg Cosell with us on 3HL. So, having said all that, walk us through that 76-yard touchdown run. What did you see there?
Well, that came out of 11 personnel, meaning they had one back, one tight end, and three wide receivers. It was a condensed formation to the wide side of the field. It was essentially an inside zone concept, but it had what we call a duo element, meaning there were two double teams inside. The tough block had to be made by Jeff Swaim on the defensive end, Gregory Rousseau, because he had the one-on-one block to play side. So that's the difficult block, because you expect the double teams to be made because it's two-on-one. So it's the one-on-one block that is really the critical block. And Swaim did an outstanding job of washing Rousseau right down. And then Westbrook Ahina made a phenomenal block on the safety Poyer, who came up to fill. So really, those two one-on-one blocks are the reason the play broke. Because as I said, if you're going to double team, you expect those blocks to be made. They're double teams.
Right, right. That's spot on.
Greg Cosell with us on 3HL. What did you see defensively from the Titans with Amani Hooker back at safety? Did you see a noticeable positive bump in what they got from the safety position there?
Well, Brent, I'd answer that this way. They had a very defined game plan approach that they stayed with all game. They did not want to give up explosive pass plays. I don't think any team goes into playing the Bills with the idea that we're going to stop the run. If they want to hand it off, that's fine. So what they did is they had a four-man rush pretty much all game. Now, at times, the fourth man was either Long or Molden, and that we call a zone exchange because it's the fourth rusher is not a D lineman. But it was essentially still a four-man rush. They played a ton of zone coverage. I don't think they played three snaps a man in the entire game. And they tried to do some disguise and late movement to obviously make Josh Allen have to think after the snap of the ball. But the whole plan was to limit explosive plays and play well in the red zone. For the most part, they did that. They got very lucky on the second red zone trip by the Bills when, for whatever reason, and only Josh Allen can answer this, I cannot. He just did not see a wide open Emmanuel Sanders. That might have changed the game. But for the most part, that was their game plan, and they stayed with it the entire game. They were just not going to give up the big pass play.
How would that plan work against the Chiefs?
Rarely does a team, Dawn, do the same thing 2 weeks in a row because it's on tape. I guess the way I'd say that is the specific nature of how they went about doing it is on tape. Can they philosophically and conceptually do something similar? Yes, but it would not be executed tactically the same way because that's on tape. So they would do it, they'd get to it in a different way. But theoretically, you do want to do the same thing because the last thing you want to do, and let's assume Tyreek Hill plays. They bring more speed to the table than the Bills. I mean, Diggs and Sanders are really good, and Beasley is what Beasley is. But there's more speed with the Chiefs, pure speed. You know, if Hill is healthy and plays a meaningful number of snaps, he can just run by people. And that's different than Diggs or Sanders. So you do, that's the last thing you want to give up. Now, I think what's really interesting in this matchup is the strength of the Titans defense has been, believe it or not, their D-line. Their D-line has played well. Landry has been very good rushing the quarterback. Simmons has played really well. I think Autry's starting to play better and is becoming a factor.
Yeah.
And one thing that the Chiefs did last week, because, and people, you know, people rip me on Twitter when I say this, but Mahomes will always put up numbers, but Mahomes has been a little all over the place this year in terms of the way he moves around. He's breaking down when he doesn't need to. He's always capable of the phenomenal play, and he can make those. But last week, because they knew that, they lined up more with two tight ends, and they made protection and emphasis so that he could be secure and comfortable in the pocket because they want to get him back playing that way. He's always going to be capable of the special second reaction movement play, but you got to execute the plays that are there. And it'll be interesting to see the approach they take this week, because as we know, the Titans D line has been pretty good rushing the quarterback.
Also, Edwards-Helaire not available. How does that change what they do conceptually on offense?
I don't think it changes anything, to be honest with you. And to be honest with you, even if Hill either doesn't play or plays limited snaps, I don't think it changes a whole lot of what they do either. Yeah. I think they play the way they play, and they're good at it. You know, they've got a great quarterback, and they play the way they play.
And defensively, for their front, if the big fella, Chris Jones, is not in, how does that affect their defensive front and our offensive line controlling this entire game?
Yeah, they've not been a very good defense this year, to be honest with you. And they do a lot of the same things, Ron, they did a year ago. They made a change this week. They replaced Daniel Sorensen, who was a starting safety, with Juan Thornhill, who's a bigger man and a better athlete. It was tough to get a read playing the Washington offense. But I think in their mind, you know, he's just a better player. They've been hurt at corner right now, and I don't know who's back and who's not back, but right now Snead is the right corner, Fenton is the left corner. When they go to their sub defenses, Snead moves inside and Hughes plays right corner, but they've struggled to stop the run. And it's interesting that they have, because the rookie Nick Bolton from Missouri, an SEC player I'm sure you're familiar with, he's a really good run defender. That's the strength of his game. But they have really struggled to stop the run, and they're doing a lot of the same things they did a year ago tactically.
Greg Cosell with us on 3HL. Before we unlock the door, Greg, can you take us through the quarterback sneak attempt at the end and what Jeffrey Simmons was able to get done there?
Well, you know, that's a hard play for me to evaluate, because Allen lost his balance. So, you know, he slipped. So I don't I don't know what would have happened if that didn't happen.
Greg.
Come on. Slay said it happened. Yeah, he said it happened because of Jeffrey.
You mean his back foot slipped because of Jeffrey Simmons?
I feel like it changed his direction and it changed his idea of how to get in the end zone.
Well, and that he was trying.
You'd have to ask Josh Allen. I can't answer that.
Okay, from Jeffrey Simmons'
standpoint.
Maybe it
did. I don't know. But I certainly can't answer that. And my guess is you probably can't either, but it sounds good.
So the Titans were guessing, I think, that the sneak was coming once he went under center.
Yeah.
And they moved their defensive front.
What they did, as soon as he started, I can't remember, did they do it before or as he started moving?
No, he started
moving
in the gun, and then as soon as he
went, he started in the gun, but when did they shift their D-line to the tight, to the reduced look?
I think they were kind of doing it as he was walking up.
As soon as he walked
up. Yeah, so we don't know if they were going to do it anyway or if it was a response to his starting to walk up. We don't know that.
Right.
Somebody knows that, but I don't.
But Simmons got across the face of the left tackle, right? That's how he was able to disrupt.
Right, but what we don't know, and this is, again, you just don't know. You don't know if he didn't slip, if maybe he would have tried to go over the top. We don't know any of this. The point is, they stopped him, you know, and that's why they won the game. But that was an interesting drive, because it started with Allen going right after Breon Borders, you know, with Simmons for the 31-yarder, and obviously that was planned because Borders was out there. So what's the status of their corners this week? I know Farley's done for the year.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Fulton's still out. He's on IR. I mean, that's
right.
It's not pretty.
I was at home watching and Davenport was in the stadium and she was like, who else do they have at corner? I go, they're all out on the field. There's nobody else.
I'm like, who's behind them? I don't even know.
Yeah, so they're going to play a ton of zone this week because they just can't match up. So they're going to
Does Jack Rabbit turn the corner, Greg?
What's that?
Does Jack Rabbit turn the corner and make Jack Rabbit-like plays, or is this Jack Rabbit-like plays what he's making right now?
I mean, I don't think that they're going to match him up to Tyreek Hill, if that's what you're asking me. First of all, if Tyreek Hill plays, they move him all around the formation. He's their movement receiver, so he doesn't line up in one place.
Yeah, he was targeted 19 times the last time the Chiefs played in Nissan Stadium.
Nigeria. Yeah, now he only played, I think, 37 snaps last week because of that quad injury. I don't know. I know he didn't practice yesterday. I haven't seen anything about today. But so many guys now, this is the killer when you're trying to, you know, build my matchup show, for instance, or just talk, is so many veterans now are going to sit out of practice on Wednesday, and right. you just don't know if that's precautionary mm-hmm. or if they really have an injury because there's that's an extra true. Game, and, you know, they just are going to sit guys out.
There he is. He's Greg Cosell, at Greg Cosell on Twitter. Give him a follow. The Install Podcast with Buck Rising and Greg Cosell. That's a must listen to deal each week as well, as is his visit with us every Thursday at 4:20. Thank you, man.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Greg.
Thanks, Greg.
There he is, Greg Cosell. When we come back, a little reaction to that. We can take your phone calls. If Darrington is still there, we'll get to Darrington. We forgot to answer his LeBron James question yesterday. So
I thought about that when I got in the car this morning.
So, yeah. That's on us, but we can do that.
What was the question?
Do I still stand beside me saying LeBron is not the guy?
Yeah. Right. Do you stand by yourself?
10 toes down. Won't move if they push me. 10 toes
that's
down.
A shot at Dawn saying she can box him out.
Oh, yeah, that too.
He knows how to use his
effort and energy.
He knows how to use his rear end, he said.
That's right.
As we broadcast so live from Music City Autoplex, 2430 Gallatin Pike will be here until 6 o'clock. This is 3HL.
The Vols have a Saturday night SEC date with Alabama. And I know at least one person who's calling for an upset.
Hey, yo, Vols fans, go Vols!
Kickoff is Saturday at 6 on your...
testicles.
Who listen, I'm done listening. It,
I'm it saying, happened at Calhoun's, according to forensics evidence. Forensic evidence? Yes.
Yeah, but
we need to take the black light onto this thing.
That looked like a hot sauce.
But if it was Thunder Road mixed with ranch.
It could have been a little. Yeah, that's true. But.
I like how honest you're being. Like, you really want to figure it out.
I do, because I stand beside what I do. And I didn't do it. So.
There you go. You didn't
ten
do
toes
it.
Down.
Right, Kirby.
Ten toes down.
Ten toes down. Won't move if
well, here's the deal. We're never going to find out. Like, the tablecloth is the same on all sides.
Oh, no. Yeah, we can find out. Uh-oh.
Christian has
There's a picture.
He has a weird pack of crackers and a picture.
Talk to me.
Slay's trying to
talk
investigate.
To me. The fact that Slay's not saying anything.
You see a sign.
The food
thing.
Hadn't arrived by then, though. No, it ain't Kirby. It's just both sides. Ain't no desk where it was at. The food hadn't arrived by then.
We know that table skirt was not used at Buffalo Wild Wings, nor was it used at Strikeout Wings.
Oh, really?
It was used at Calhoun's in Knoxville.
Listen, when I eat,
which
let me tell you
this. The last thing I saw
all the time.
The last thing I saw before you guys went to Calhoun's in Knoxville was you chugging a beer.
Right. And then you look at that picture and I got two beers that's on the table.
That's not a good precursor to wing sauce on the table.
That more so I'm looking for the beer instead of the wing. Uh-huh. But
what's funny
say,
is you're not really a beer guy.
No, I am at tailgates.
Oh.
I'm
that's how I am.
Yeah, I am at tailgates, yeah. But
you gotta be at the right spot. Like if you're at a game, football game, like beer.
There you go. See, that's what I'm saying. But when I eat sauce and I drip sauce falls on me because I don't eat over the table. I eat like, if you ever watch me eat, I eat like
we
this.
Do not watch you eat.
I know.
Just for the record.
But I eat
it happens
time,
too
so
fast.
So y'all got to watch me. No, but I eat and then, yeah, that does happen fast. But I eat and I come to me. I don't eat and go to it. Aha. Mm-hmm. No, I'm kidding. No, I ain't dropping no sauce. No.
Can I say that's actually a pretty good argument?
Thank you, Babs.
Yeah.
Thank
not
you.
Bad.
That's well done.
Babs is headed to Minnesota.
Soda.
Try to throw it on Babs.
What the heck?
He threw a bug on Babs.
No, I didn't. It didn't go anywhere.
He threw a BB.
Don't flick it. Then it's going to smell. Bug. That's Did how you? Stink bugs work. Oh, yeah.
All right. Memphis All Grizzlies right. won their opener 132-121.
Are you watching NBA already?
I am watching.
So you are well, not you. I can't have this conversation with you. Does
what?
Does that? Casual NBA
really?
Fan like?
Yeah.
Because you're gonna watch NBA way more than
this is true.
Than I am, honestly.
Listen.
But do you watch at the beginning and then the end?
This team's gonna be fun to watch, man. They scored 132 or more last season 5 times. They did it in their opener.
It's because there's no defense.
Ja Morant. Well, there was no defense last year either.
Yeah.
Ja Morant was 17-29 from the floor. He scored 37 points,
really
6
well.
Rebounds, 6 assists. Morant scored at least 37 only 3 times last season.
Yep.
He's going to be something this year.
Yeah, give a shout-out to the native. The native by Indiana, Darius Garland.
Darius Garland had 14 assists.
Had a double-double. So, yeah, salute
Where did
him.
That stink bug go?
It's in Christian's
Kirby
jacket.
Flicked
he
no.
flicked it on Christian. It's probably one of the crackers he just ate.
Kirby flicked it on the other side of Chris the world.
Grizzlies playing Clippers Saturday at 9:30. Braves and Astros, one win away from the World Series.
I need to know what to do with that and the dot. Hung, I want to ask you so bad.
Okay. We'll talk about it when we come back. Also get you the Tennessee Titans injury report along with the Kansas City Chiefs. Yesterday, the Chiefs had more players on the injury report than the Titans.
What about Darrington?
Oh, yeah, we got to take Darrington.
I got a question to answer for Darrington, too.
I thought you had a question for Darrington.
Nah.
No, he asked about LeBron.
Yeah.
But he also wants to talk about AJ, who had a tweet that just went out not too long ago. We've got all that coming up. Stay tuned. 3HL 104.5 The Zone.
Boom.
Buck Rising loves him some Urban Meyer.
I think that almost daily we should have an Urban Meyer update.
Up through Smyrna, seeing heavy police activity at Sam Ridley Parkway heading eastbound right after Old Nashville Highway to Lowry Street. It is currently closed from police activity. We also have an injury accident at Fester's Lane south of Murfreesboro Pike. And Pegram dealing with a wreck at I-40 westbound right at McCrory Lane and another crash at Murfreesboro Pike east to Smith Springs Road. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football. 104.5 The Zone.
From the WinBet studio, win with WinBet. WTFX Gallatin, Nashville.
Accumulate. Media station.
The Titans and the Chiefs. Kickoff is Sunday at noon on your home for Titans football. Trending now at 104.5 The Zone.
But who is going to be on the field Sunday at Nissan Stadium? The injury report is out for both the Chiefs and the Titans. First for the Titans, the players that did not practice, A.J. Brown, bathroom. You also have Taylor Lewan still out with the concussion issues. Chester Rogers was out today with groin issues. The King was out with greatness. Now, the thing is, when it comes to the full participants, though, when you're looking at your guys like Mike Blassingame, he was a full participant today, as was Roger Saffold and Randy Bullock. Now, the ones for the Chiefs, look, it's lengthy, okay? But the one player that you need to be paying attention to that was not on the practice field yesterday or today would be Tyreek Hill with a quad injury. But for all your foundation and waterproofing repair needs, you need to go visit our friends at USSTN.com. Breaking news at once on your home for the Vols, your flagship station for your Tennessee Titans, and home to 3HL. This is 104.5 The Zone.
The 3HL with Brent Doherty, Don Davenport, and Ron Slay.
Yo, what up, Nashville 3HL on 104.5 The Zone. Don Davenport has exited stage left, which means you're left with me, Brent Doherty, and this guy over here, now at the end of the table.
Yeah. Hey, I'm in the build. Best believe I'm in the build. Better be ready. I'm in the build. Car ain't got no rules. Time for the show. Best believe I'm in the building.
What a beautiful day in the Music City, man. At least out here in the Rivergate area. We drove through 65 North through Brentwood. I couldn't even see anybody. Anything. It was raining so hard. But, man, I just walked outside during the break. It's perfect.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Like, I mean, perfect. By the way, Greg Cosell, we had on earlier. If you missed him,
yes,
definitely check out the podcast. He breaks it down. He told us, as we talk right now, you can make the argument that Derrick Henry is the most dominant player in the NFL. I want to have an MVP conversation.
I want some, too.
Because I hear people say he shouldn't even be in the mix. And if you go to Vegas and you try to get some odds on Derrick Henry to win the MVP, you'll get a lot of value. Because I saw one place had nine guys on there, and none of them were him.
And what I dislike about this entire conversation we're about to have, this award is now biased. It's biased, man. Like, they made it
it's
a quarterback
the best quarterback.
That's it, man.
And what's funny, and Chris Johnson told us this a while ago. He said, look, what's funny now in the NFL, because the quarterback's won it eight times in a row.
Right.
He goes, the quarterback wins the NFL MVP, and then the running back wins the offensive player of the year.
And that's whack, man. They ought to switch it, and so it doesn't mess up anything. They ought to switch the awards. Make the MVP a running back award, and make the quarterback offensive MVP award.
Or like, just give it to the most valuable player to his team in the NFL.
That's going to be the gray area.
And look, man, I get people that say, look, Lamar Jackson is unreal and all of these things. I think Lamar Jackson should be in the conversation.
No, he's in it.
But Lamar Demetrius Jackson Jr. completes 67.5% of his passes for 280 yards. Okay. Mm-hmm. Nine touchdowns, five interceptions, and he's lost two fumbles.
Yeah.
Is that the MVP, or is it the guy that's doing things no one's ever done before, the MVP?
And see, that's what I was going to say. I'll take it a step further with you. We've seen what Lamar Jackson is doing.
And it's phenomenal.
Yes, without question. The way he's keeping them in games, fighting to come back. What Derrick Henry is doing, we've never, ever, ever seen. Especially if he goes and break this 1,000-yard mark after game seven.
Which Rhett Bryan, Rhett Bryan clued us into that four games ago.
Sure did.
Watch him get close to this. Only four times in the history of the league. O.J. Simpson did it twice. Only three dudes have gone 1,000 yards in seven games.
Now, this is the stuff we're witnessing. Who was the last? O.J., right?
I don't remember. I had the list in front of me when we were talking about it.
Well, whoever it was, it's 20-plus
years. It was
years.
Jim Brown, O.J. Simpson, and
in 20-plus years. Still 20 years.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're not seeing this. We will see this other performance by a quarterback again.
I get the argument that last year doesn't have anything to do with this year, but when you're talking about this guy, I think it does.
And when you're talking about running.
And here's the other thing. Like, he's on pace to break the 2105 because they have 17 games. Watch him do it in 16 if he stays healthy.
Then that should shut everything
up. He's on pace for 2088 right now, which would be back-to-back 2,000-yard seasons. Never been done. Never been close.
Come on, man.
And it's too early to have this conversation. But if we're going to have this conversation, and national guys not even going to include Derrick Henry, as Austin Huff said, don't let Shannon Sharp beat you to a tape.
Right. And I don't think it's too early because when quarterbacks are playing phenomenal in the first four or five games of the year, it's always like this. If you think back last year, Russell Wilson was a lock to get the MVP, without question. Then the season went on and it changed. Tom Brady cut on. Like, it's so much more, man. You got guys that's doing it. And this guy in a pass-happy league where the box is stacked still is running uncontrollably. Like, it's Derrick Henry ain't got no roof. Zero roof. Like, come on. Hey, man. Come on, man. You got to recognize what's real at some point.
615-737-1045. Let's get Darrington in here.
What up, Darrington?
We owe him an answer from yesterday. But go ahead and Darrington, I know you want to talk about A.J. Brown, but hit that question from yesterday, too.
I got you. And just when I say, hey, Slay, your remix, the end of it, the mix, the beat part, it sounds like the song from Real Steel when the kid was dancing with the robot. I don't know why I get that vibe from that. That's what I hear.
That's you dancing with me, Darrington.
I've never danced with a robot. That's pretty good.
That's what it sounded like. And then A.J. Brown, you said you can't eat. I got the perfect plan for you. Now, if the NFL drug policy is like the NBA, come holler at me. I got the perfect session for you, and we'll take care of all that for you real quick. You'll be eating in no time. Now, next, Slay, you are also 1,000% right. I'm trying to make this real quick. Okay. Slay, you was 1,000% right. Josh Allen had a little thing where somebody asked him what happened. He said the play was walk up to the line and snap the ball. When the Titans shifted, his initial plan was to go over the top. Mm-hmm. So after he seen what happened to Dak Prescott, he wanted to go under. When he went under, he said Jeffrey grabbed him and he slipped. That's the only reason why he slipped is because Jeffrey grabbed him. So in effect, you are 1,000% right. And that came from the quarterback's mouth. Now, Bill MVP. Only way Derrick Henry gets the MVP is if he does it in 16 games because they're going to say it took him 17 to do it. Boom.
Yeah.
Now.
I agree.
Now, because you still got Kyler Murray and then you got a 44-year-old for the throw for 6,000 yards almost.
Right.
Real weird.
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Now, my question. Oh, and then so after you answer my question, say about LeBron, Greg, could you answer this for me? Do you feel that with the Titans starting to decline in health and the Colts actually getting healthier, do you think it could be because of the season has going that the competition, if Tennessee loses the game, that they actually could just go to the playoffs just by winning the division only and the coach having a better record just because of health only and then Slay? Do you still stand by what you said, the King, not King Henry, but King James,
which
I think them two have in correlation. They are freakish athletes that we've never seen before that I don't think can ever be emulated. But do you still think that he is not the man, and Durant is officially taking over? Because I think Giannis owns Durant right now. I'm just saying. Okay. All right, fellas, I'm listening.
Right.
See you, dude.
You want to go first?
You
want to hit that one and come back?
T.Y. Hilton came back. That helps them. They're playing better football for sure.
Carson Wentz getting healthier.
Yeah, and I think they kind of understand what they are with him now.
Yes.
Better. But they just had a safety go down, too, that's going to affect them.
Big time.
So, you know, I don't know. The Titans have a two-game lead with a game in hand. The Colts really screwed themselves or got screwed by Lamar Jackson, either way you look at it. Mm-hmm. But the Colts screwed themselves. They had a field goal blocked and another one missed. You make one of those two, you win that Baltimore game. You're 3-3 right now.
Yep.
And you're putting a lot more pressure on the Titans. So as of right now, you know, the Titans have a clear shot for sure. But with the Titans injuries, man, who's playing corner? You?
Man, we know who it ain't. It ain't Forson.
Yeah.
We need him back.
LeBron at 36 went for 34 in the opener.
And shot a great percentage in game one of 82. So my whole thing is, listen, he got rest coming into the season. Mm-hmm. Do I think he's still the guy? No, I do not. And the reason being, in order to be the guy for them to win a championship, Darrington, it has to be AD. AD has to carry the load for that team. That is what he's there. That's what he's there to do.
Yep.
LeBron is supposed to be the Robin. Now, his overall, him himself, like, he's cast a huge shadow. A huge shadow. Like, he will still be in consideration if they go to the finals for the finals MVP. I believe he'll still be in the MVP race if he plays enough games. I doubt he plays that many games. But that's just saying, this team is geared to play in the playoffs. We'll see when it comes to the playoffs. Leaving off last year, I think KD, I'm going with KD. That's just, and I'm one of the biggest LeBron fans. I'm going with KD, and I still stand beside that just because LeBron can't carry that load, especially on the defensive end. Like, it ain't even though he almost need to play the five on defense, which is the center position. So, I do stand beside that.
So, Russ with the triple single the other day. Is that going
to
work?
No, they need to figure that out. This man playing like he's at the community center. I don't know what Russ out there doing, man. They better hurry up and figure that out, though. By All-Star break, they need to be intact. And at this pace, I'm not sure Russ will be there because Rondo understands his role. Russ doesn't understand his role. Melo does. LeBron does. AD does. You got Malik Monk. You got guys that understand the role. Russ doesn't understand it. He's never had to play without the ball. So we'll have to see how that goes.
Just go to Waffle House. Talk it out. It'll be all right. All right, when we come back, we'll take a deep dive into the Chiefs and Titans. 615-737-1045, you want in. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay, broadcasting live from Music City Autoplex. Check them out online, musiccityautoplex.com. Ron Slay will take a test drive with you if you come out here.
I sure will.
We'll be right back.
Friday night, it's CPA at Lipscomb Academy on the 104.5 The Zone Game of the Week. Presented by the Tennessee Highway Safety Office and Paul Winkler Investing. Coverage starts Friday night at 6:30 with Will Bowling and Lucas Panzica on your home for high school football. 104.5 The Zone.
What up, people? What up, what up, what up, what up, what up, what up? It's me, Ron Slay. I'm here to talk to you, tell you about buying a car. Where do you need to go? Music City Autoplex. I'm telling you right now. I'm here right now. So if you were to come on down here to 2430 Gallatin Pike, then not only could you test drive the car, but I'll get in the car and tell you everything that's wrong with it because I'll ride around with you. And I'll be sure to lock the door when we got in the car. But outside of that, friendly customer service here. I'm guaranteeing the atmosphere is everything you want. I even took the opportunity to come up here and get my car washed. That's how much I love it up here. So you come up here, it's a guarantee that you find what you're looking for. The selection is huge. Matter of fact, it is the biggest selection in Middle Tennessee. And I stand beside it. Over 300 low-mileage cars for you to pick from. You don't like one? Look at them. I mean, you can open up your eyes, man. The lot is huge. Matter of fact, you can come up here and do some conditioning around the Music City Autoplex lot. If you ain't did no conditioning and got out and walked, come up here and walk this lot. I guarantee you're going to lose some weight. It's that much you need to look to. But if you don't want to do that, go to musiccityautoplex.com. Check them out online, and you can pick your car that way. I'm guaranteeing it. I stand beside it, man. Music City Autoplex, them and Big Slay. Car ain't got no roof. They got cars that ain't got no roof. Come up here and check it out. Come get your car.
Frequent heartburn may keep you from running your A game, but it doesn't have to anymore. Join the Prilosec OTC 2-week challenge. Just go to PriloSecOTC.com. You'll get $3 off to get you started, plus 14 days of tips, tricks, and reminders. Just 2 weeks, zero heartburn. Go to PriloSecOTC.com and sign up today. Zero heartburn is possible with Prilosec OTC. Use as directed for 14 days to treat frequent heartburn, not for immediate relief.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? So your headlights are getting dim? With the seasons changing, now's a great time to change them. Upgrading your headlights can ensure you'll be safe and ready to handle darkness and fog. Oh, and we recommend replacing in pairs. That way you won't have uneven lighting over time. You can get all of your lighting needs fast with our next day delivery and free same day store pickup. Getting the job done just got easy.
Get in the zone, AutoZone.
Restrictions and details at AutoZone.com.
If you're looking for flooring and you absolutely, positively have to know you're getting the best price, the choice is clear. At Buy Floors Direct, we buy direct from the factory in massive quantities and sell direct to you from our huge, clean warehouse without retail markups. The decor stores and home centers have expensive retail locations, fancy displays, and middleman costs, and that means you'll pay more. Come in and see why contractors and designers buy their flooring at a Buy Floors Direct warehouse. These pros are always telling us how our quality floors are priced far lower than the retail stores. Our warehouses are full of tile.
tickets to see your Tennessee Titans face off against their remaining 2021 home opponents at Nissan Stadium, thanks to Kentucky legend. Be caller number 5 now for a chance to win Titans Chiefs tickets, 615-737-1045. That's 615-737-1045. For more information on Titans Ticket Tuesday, presented by Kentucky legend, visit 1045thezone.com. We also have some audio coming up as O.J. Simpson weighs in on the MVP debate. Before we play that for you, we haven't heard it yet.
Lord have mercy.
But before, is you think O.J.'s in the car with the king?
I mean, all I'm saying is, man, O.J., let us figure this out on our own for a second, man. Then we're going to come back to you. We'll double back around if we need a couple more people to hop in the car.
We're using him as the base on this.
The face of the King Henry MVP campaign is O.J. Simpson.
You can sit down. No, you're good.
Man, tell somebody O.J. the wrong time, man, to be at the podium. Don't be there, too.
You think O.J. would come on the show?
Yeah,
he'd kill it.
Yeah. That and the votes, like, it'll be over. Like, he killed the whole thing. Like,
before we play the O.J. sound, who does O.J. think should be the MVP right now? We'll play it in a second. Oh, let's bring in Savagery. Ramon Foster, VFL, barbecue spiller, perhaps. I don't know.
Hey, man, the people want to know, man.
All right, so, Ramon, this is where we are with the barbecue investigation. We've got Keith Morrison from Dateline. He's all in on this deal. So apparently, the table skirt with the barbecue stain on it was not used at Buffalo Wild Wings, and it was not used at Strikeout Wings, but it was used at Calhoun's in Knoxville. We've got photographic evidence of Ron Slay on one side of the table and you on the other side of the table, so we're down to 2.
Yeah.
Hey, who's snitching, man? That's all I gotta say. Did Jeremy Pruitt call in?
Hey, man, it might have been Pruitt.
You've never seen somebody get hung up on so quick. If that man called in the show.
Hey, Savvy.
You know, yeah.
All I'm saying is, man, I don't know if they're trying to set it up or they're trying to turn us against each other or what, man. But I know they had me in the room, and I know they had you in the room, and you know what I mean? Yeah, I know both of us standing 10 toes down in it. So then they try to bring Kirby in as a lead investigator, and we ain't biting.
All I'm telling you is this. I sat in the room. Now, I ate the meal, but I ain't say nothing.
Yeah, the meal was good. Needed that.
That's all I did. I didn't say anything. Now, what happened in Knox Vegas stays in Knox Vegas now.
There we go.
Except for we have a picture with Now, Ron Slay has a ton of food in front of him. I mean, the whole menu, Ramon. And you don't have any food in front of you that I can see. But you do have a napkin that would go right about where that barbecue stain might be.
Hey, man, they dissecting and everything, Savvy. I don't know what's going on.
You're going to get the black light.
I know they did. Now listen, I plead the 5th until you speak to my lawyer.
What about you stuff in the ballot box yesterday in that little contest? You plead the 5th there too?
Brent, now look. I'm for the kids and a great cause, okay? So the people, I love the people. I'm with the people. That's all we have for the fam, okay? But what I'm telling you is I wasn't going to lose the Babs, okay? I didn't care if I had to write a big check myself. I wasn't losing to Babs.
Which may or may not have happened.
I don't think
you understand that. Yeah, right.
But ultimately, you're right. It went for breast cancer awareness. So yeah, we're all good there. Hey, before we get into the Titans, let's all listen to this O.J. Simpson cut real quick. Who does O.J. think should be the MVP in the NFL at this point? Roll it.
Punk went to sleep.
It's me, miles, I'm
just about over that Buffalo Bills defeat to the Titans the other night. I've been seeing Josh Allen's foot slip down on the goal line in my sleep, but I can't take anything away from the Titans. Hey, man, those guys are tough. They play my type of football. Rock 'em, sock 'em, smash mouth football. Double teams, pull a guard, and hey, King Henry, the Bills hadn't given up one running touchdown all season, and Henry got three the other night. Man, the man is amazing, and he's playing for a coach that believes in running the football. I was watching TV today, you know, the sports shows, and they were talking about who's MVP, and they were talking about quarterbacks. Well, I beg to differ. The difference between the top three quarterbacks in scoring and fantasy is less than a point. From first to 10th is almost 30 points, maybe 28 points. But when you start talking about running backs, the difference between first and third is about 60 points. And the difference between first, which is King Henry, and I believe is Joe Mixon, 10th, is almost 90 points. Yeah. Oh, my God, about 95 points. Hey, to me, at this stage of the season, right now, the MVP of this league, nobody has separated themselves from the next player in their position like King Henry has. And, you know, Dickerson and I have had a talk. We discussed a few times this year with 17 games if he's going to break his record. Well, we got different opinions about that, but we'll just have to wait and see and talk about that a little later. In any event, hey, guys, wear your mask. If you haven't got your shots, go get it. Take care.
Hey, man. Hey, okay.
Is anybody terrified at the moment? Like, I mean,
first?
Just the tone of his voice, man.
It was a long-distance phone call. He wasn't right beside him when he talked to him. It was far away.
Hey,
we have
Dickerson. I'm afraid for myself of Eric Dickerson if he went against OJ.
Hey, that's
we've seen what
guess
happens.
What, though? Guess what, though? This is what I'm saying. Hey, OJ, you got some valid points, man.
He does.
But what I need you to do is tell them to me in the back and then let me come out and present it. I ain't even going to say from an anonymous source. Because, OJ, I just need you to be cool. I need you to be cool, brother. Don't, like then you jump out there up. Telling people to get shots and wear masks. Like, hey, come on, OJ, man. Like,
he knows.
Yeah, just be cool, brother. Just be cool. That's what
the
I need
face of the Derrick Henry MVP campaign is OJ Simpson. This is where we are.
Now, I'll say this. What OJ got his issues, and we know that he's serious. I'll never downplay them. But to have him, if we're looking at his professional career, say this about a guy like Derrick Henry. He, like Ron said, his points are valid, and I didn't realize the separation to him between the next available running back in the league is 90-plus points. I've seen today, just honestly, yeah, it's fantasy. I've seen today and all this week, though, you've seen the four-letter network, you've seen all these other people saying the same thing about Derrick Henry. He's on notice right now as far as this.
Yeah, Mo, and then this
Patrick
is what you
brought up the fact that Dan Patrick brought up the fact that Derrick Henry is more like Randy Moss, to where you know Randy was going to get the ball, but you couldn't stop him. That's the same way you got to look at Derrick Henry at this point. Man, that was a great point to be made.
Yeah. Yeah. That's spot on.
And here's the other thing. Lamar Jackson's turned it over 7 times. So I know he's a great player and all this stuff, and he's going to have big numbers, but he's not doing – like, Derrick Henry's doing things we've never seen before.
Yep.
He is – and Brent, to that point, and Ron also, is this. If Derrick Henry wants this recognition, he has got to do this against what we or what everybody holds as the marquee teams. He did it against Buffalo, who's the darlings. He did it against – well, he didn't really do it against Seattle. He beat Seattle. You got to do it against Kansas City, who's got the MVP on their team. You got to do it against Pittsburgh. You got to do it against the Rams. You got to do it against the 49ers. You do it against those marquee teams – big market, traditional teams, that's when his name, that's when his buzz, that's when respect factor comes in. I know the city's always talking about we need our respect when it comes to him, but you got to perform against those A-type teams, man, even if they have a losing record. If you embarrass them on national TV, then you still raise the eyebrows of everybody watching them, because I'll say this, no matter how bad Kansas City is, they're probably still going to be the favorite in most games simply because of 15.
Yeah. That's right.
The line, by the way, since you brought that up, was 5.5. It's down to 4.5.
Is
so
it?
Some money coming in on the Titans. And you're right. I mean, Derrick Henry busts a 76-yard touchdown run on Monday Night Football against one of the best teams in the NFL. So maybe he'll get a little more attention. I asked Roger Saffold about the play where Derrick Henry ran over Micah Hyde, where he just kind of stepped over the top of him, and he just started smiling before I even finished my question. But Saffold said, I asked them to run that play again, which led me down what I thought was an interesting path, and I want to get your take on this, that there's a conversation between Titans players and the OC about what they're seeing on the field, what they feel like is working, and that they come to kind of a collective decision on some stuff. And I thought that was really interesting. Did you guys handle it that way at Pittsburgh?
Yes, 100%, especially with Mike Munchak. It was him. Yeah. He'd be like, what you guys want to run? We were like, hey, run double, run pike, run counter. Like, it was those type of things when you know you had the front that you wanted. And I know Buffalo had high stats, but as a player and run, you know this too. Sometimes them stats don't mean nothing to you.
Right.
You have to go out there and give work no matter what. And I felt like this past weekend, well, this past Monday night, I even saw from Taylor. They get a first down, he's jogging down the field and pointing in that direction. It looked like the old Taylor, man. And I got a feeling this line took a step this past game. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't perfect, but they did something they hadn't done all year. No sacks, and they just dominated a really good NFL defense, man. So, yeah, I'm sure those guys were chomping at the bit, trying to get as many plays as they could against that front that they were seeing against Buffalo. It was theirs for the taking, man, and Raj is that type of guy. Dial it up, coach. Like, we offensive linemen don't have a whole lot to say, but when we know we got one on the line, we're going to take it every single time, and that's what Roger was saying.
And that's the thing. We asked him, and, like, how do you go out and get ready for this game and defend a team like Kansas City and Patrick Mahomes? And he said, we take it upon ourselves, man. The best defense for the Kansas City Chiefs is keeping Patrick Mahomes off the field. So I think that's spot on. Like, you come in there, that speaks to the mentality that you're talking about, and it also speaks to where they are. You, like, we are seeing it. Brent pointed out before the show, and Quisenberry, man, he was playing. And then Saffold also talked about Lamb. Like, Lamb came in, messed up a little bit at first, and then he got warm and got it going, and, you know, he leaned on me. I'm giving him advice. Like, so you're starting to see that communication. You're starting to see them join as a unit. And I don't know if we'll look at this in about 2 weeks, and maybe you can speak to this. And this is no knock to him because he had a lot going on. But getting Sambrelo out and him going on and saying, like, hey, man, I'm done. Did that kind of remove any negative energy or a black cloud or whatever it may have been? You know, like, because you got to have every – you said it, man. It's only one – it's one group in the NFL that moves as a unit and depends on each other as much as they do, and that's the offensive line.
100%. And I'll say this, too. We had a guy quit on us in camp, and was going to make the team, honestly. And all it did for us, and this was in camp, though, it made us bond closer together because it had us, like you said, as a group, we need all the bodies that we can because at any point in time, you can be out from a roll-up or something. So when you have a guy like that pulls out on you, right, wrong, and indifferent, I'm not judging him from it. I think it probably brings that group a little bit closer. I think it makes that group say, hey, this is all we got. It's us against everybody else, including people who've been in this building. And that may have done them some good, man. And, again, I wish the best for Sambrelo, but I'm sure that group in a side chat somewhere said, hey, screw him. Let's go. Let's show him that he wanted to be a part of this or something.
I love it. At Ramon Foster on Twitter. Thanks for jumping in for your weekly visit on Thursday from J. Martin Ramon. Thank you, Ramon.
Hey, Juju, go kill it, man. I know my boy in the car, if he ain't already dropped off, he had practice already.
Man, no, we on the way to Clarksville now. He got his head down with his headphones and doing homework. Athlete and a scholar. Uncle Ron, say what's up, RJ.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what
you
I'm talking about.
You hear me in the background, so I'm going to tell him I said what's up. His voice ain't that deep.
Man, you still Jun-Jun, man. You still Jun-Jun.
He said you still Jun-Jun.
Those two, as tall as they are, going to need that car with no roof.
Right.
All right, Ramon, thanks, man. We'll be listening to you next week. Enjoy your day off tomorrow.
Absolutely.
All right, there he is. Savage Radio.
That's it, bro. That is it. Hey,
does anybody want to tell Austin Huff that he has a passenger in his Derrick Henry MVP mobile?
Yeah, you tell me why. He might want to be.
You better not lock that door.
Yeah, don't lock that door.
Head on the swivel. Make sure you ain't got no roof. You got to be able to jump out and roll, baby.
He's talking about wearing masks and stuff. Like, I don't know, man.
He's an expert.
Yeah, Quesberry did grade out well, according to PFF, yeah, at right tackle. So that's a great time to see it. And Kendall Lamb did play well, and as the action continued to go, kind of like Chris Jackson out there at corner.
Yeah.
When we come back, Georgia's defense has some unbelievable stats. You're going to be blown away. And it's time for the parlay.
Yes.
That's next on 104.5 The Zone.
Blaine Bishop and Mickey Ryan.
What is going on? This team won the division last year, has a chance to moonwalk away with the division this year. Can't get out of its own way.
To me, when you're young, injured from what? I mean, let's go. Yeah, Farley, I hear he's practicing. He's getting back into a groove, and then boom, shoulder. Yeah, we need these guys in the worst way, so, you know. Because you're like, dang, you just got here. You're not even beat up yet. You're right. Not the NFL beat up.
Right. Tomorrow from 1 to 3 on 104.5 The Zone.
If you're thinking about that flooring project, I've got the perfect people for you. Buddy Allen Carpet One, local company here in Nashville. They're over in Donaldson, 2405 at Lebanon Pike in Donaldson. Locally owned and operated by the Allen family for more than 55 years. Zach Jennett and Judson Allen are in the store every day. They're huge sports fans, but they're big fans of you guys. When you go to see them, they are going to give you the red carpet treatment, literally, unless you want a different color than red. Then they have all the colors, but you know what I'm saying. And they're going to handle the project, all aspects of the project, including the installation. Not going to farm that out to anybody like the big box stores. They'll handle it all, so you'll always know who to call with any question you might have. That phone number is 615-883-3289, buddyallencarpet1.com.
What tools are building the Nashville skyline and are chosen by pros everywhere? What tools have a home right here in Jackson, Tennessee, and on the toughest job sites all around the world? DeWalt. We build the tools that are building Tennessee and the world. Because DeWalt tools are guaranteed tough. Tennessee tough. If they don't measure up, they don't get painted yellow. DeWalt, guaranteed tough. Learn more at DeWalt.com.
What up, people? You know who it is. Yep, it's me, Ron Slay. I got something to tell you. Strike out wings. That's where you need to go. 2521 Nolensville Pike, right off 440. Or this one right out here where we are, by Music City Autoplex. 123 Ewing Drive in the original Prince's location. Y'all know I'm very, very serious when it comes to the food, especially wings. So you know I'm serious when I tell you about Steakout Wings. Yes, you can break it down like that or you can say it together. Steakout Wings. Either one. It's all good. 69 sitting wings on Tuesday. They have the NFL Sunday tickets, so you need to get there. Watch it Sunday or Monday. Monday, you can join me. I'll be in there having me some good cold ones, get my sweet and sassy lemon pepper mix. I'm going to get them to change that to the Big Slay flavor. So when they get that, then you wash it down with some Kool-Aid and the ranch Cajun fries. You can't lose, man. You can't lose. It's easy as 1, 2, 3. Strike out the wings.
You just perfected that mango steam parfait recipe that Becca from accounting said was impossible.
This is gonna be great.
Marty bet 17 whole dollars that you could do it, and you didn't let him down. You grab a step stool to help capture that perfect overhead beauty shot when the dog comes racing.